It's April 1st. Daffodils are popping up, and folks are eager to get their hands in the dirt.
Very excited. I like working out in the yard, so I always look forward to April.
Uh-huh. It's been a long winter.
It's had a very long winter.
Mike Bass stopped in this new Hy-Vee Garden Center that just opened today, where we found Jerry Kluver pleased to be putting out the pansies.
You're going to want to set one or two of these out there to really give you the feeling that spring has arrived.
Kluver advises you not to touch your yard just yet.
If you walk out into the grass right now, it's probably muddy, it's wet from melting snow and the little rain we got, and you go in there with a wire rake, you might be able to do more damage than you really realize.
Kluver says wait about 10 days to evaluate your yard and rake it after the soil warms up. Then apply crabgrass preventer. In 3 weeks, put down mold control to keep the critters from tearing up the lawn.
If part of your lawn was burned out by the drought like this, you'll know in about 2 weeks whether it will come back. If you don't see new growth then, you'll have to reseed or resod it.
You may want to put some new topsoil or some good peat in there and then lay the grass seed down.
It'll be time to mow in about 3 weeks. By June 1st, put down grub control. Although you can plant cold crops like potatoes, onions, and radishes now, wait till after the frost-free date to put in flowers and get growing.
But cucumbers, your peppers, your tomatoes, wait for the frost-free dates, which are May 10th, and then we should be really ready to go in full swing with gardening here in 2013.